G'day folks. In this video I'm making some wheels for 1/24 scale slot car models. I'll be drilling using a slot drill, a boring bar and a parting tool. I'll also be using the cam simulation followed by the machining format that was popular in the last video. In this program, the first line N10 establishes that we are using absolute measurement, using millimeters and using feed per rev, not millimeters per minute. Next line N15 is start of the subroutine 1. The next line N20 is selecting tool number 2, and the next line N30 is the X and Z 0 settings for tool 2. Here the tool moves into position and we have a program halt to position the material. Then we have a 5-second dwell for the motor to get up to speed, and we face off. Tool was already in position, as was the material. This is the dwell that we have, and the motor gets up to speed, and then we face off. Here the parting tool is using a stock removal can cycle to create the profile that we want. And here you can see it doing it on the actual piece. The parting insert I'm using is a profiling insert rather than just a grooving insert. It's a Sumitomo ML type and it works quite well. Here we're using a 6mm spot drill followed by a 3mm stub drill, drilling the hole. These are both held in the turret. I know I keep apologising for my turret having backlash, but it's there. And until I fix it, getting tools to be on centre is almost an impossibility. For some weird reason, and I have no idea why, a slot drill is not part of the library in this old software. You'd think they'd have had the foresight to do that. So you just have to visualise it as having all that material removed instead of the material that's left there by a normal drill. Here's the slot drill going in, cleaning out the material nice and square for the 8mm boring bar to go in. There's the 8mm boring bar held in a block in the turret. Just sped it up a little there. Move the video along. And this is the final two cuts. Cleaning it up. Now we have a grooving can cycle, taking three cuts to remove lots of material. You see there's no pecking there, they're just straight cuts going in. Here you can see it on the machine. Unfortunately, it's difficult to see, but you can see lots of swarf flying out of the groove. Really a good insert. Here we finish the profile and part it off and move the tool back to the beginning again. You can see the tool moving down inside, runs along the hub and parts off. And back to the program start position. Tapping these things off as I would normally do is quite difficult because I was likely to damage them against the parting tool, and there was virtually no space to get my hand in there to pick the things out. It's very difficult. So I came up with the idea of putting some heat shrink on some old pliers, and I got round the problem that way. It really worked quite well. I thought you might like to see some shots of wear on the inserts. No, not that one, that's a new one. But this is a worn one, and you can see there's quite a bit of chipping around the edge. That's not the one I was using on this job, that was another one. This is the one I was using on this job that I changed. You can see there's quite a bit of wear along the front edge. Right, now we'll do a run through of the thing from a different angle, so you can see the turret and this will be the whole thing done in one hit. I would like to take this opportunity to thank those of you who left comments on the last video. That video was really successful. It's on about 4,000 views now. Normally in that length of time a video of mine would be 1,500, 2,000 views. So thank you for your comments, most appreciated. It was great to hear that you liked the way I'd done it. So if you have any comments you'd like to leave regarding this video, that would be great. In a moment you'll get to see the parting tool throwing up all those chips. There's the specs if anybody's interested in exactly the tool I'm using. They're really brilliant. They're very hard body. I had to use an angle grinder to shorten that one to put it in the turret. Usually you can use a hacksaw. This is the finish that I got from the parting tool. I was quite pleased with that. And this is the finish I got on the inside from the boring bar. Those axles are a little bit undersized for what I was asked to put in the wheels as holes, but that's what it looks like. Thank you for watching.